Welcome to Civil Engineering In. Aerial footage of iconic sea bridges. Bridges, they connect cities, unite communities, and keep the world moving. But have you ever wondered how engineers build these massive structures over deep, unpredictable water? Hello, welcome back to Civil Engineering Edge. Ever wondered how massive bridges stand tall over deep oceans? Let's dive into the engineering secrets behind these modern marvels right now. In today's video, we're diving deep, quite literally, into the fascinating world of how bridges are built over deep water. From underwater site analysis to concrete piers rising above the surface, we'll explore the step-by-step process using real-life engineering marvels like the Confederation Bridge in Canada as our guide. 1. Site analysis, the first step beneath the surface. Before a single piece of steel is placed, engineers must conduct a comprehensive site analysis. This involves studying water depth, current strength, seabed or riverbed soil conditions, tidal movements, and weather patterns. For example, when building the Confederation Bridge, which stretches 12.9 kilometers, 8 miles across the Northumberland Strait, engineers had to assess water depths ranging from 45 meters, 148 feet, to 60 meters, 197 feet. They also had to consider strong tidal currents, harsh winter ice, seismic stability, accessibility for construction machinery. The goal, to choose a location that not only minimizes construction challenges, but also ensures long-term durability and cost-effectiveness. 2. Bridge design. Engineering meets imagination. Once the location is finalized, the next step is designing the bridge. This involves answering key questions. What type of bridge is best suited? Suspension, cable stick, or beam bridge? What will be the size, shape, and structure of key components like piers and deck spans? How much load, stress, and environmental force must it withstand? Using advanced computer modeling and simulations, engineers ensure the bridge design can withstand everything from heavy vehicle traffic and high winds to the unpredictable force of deep water. 3. Choosing the right bridge type. Strength meets strategy. Not all bridges are built the same. In fact, the type of bridge selected plays a major role in its success, especially over deep water. Let's take a quick look at the most common bridge types. Beam bridges, simple and cost-effective, ideal for short spans over narrow water channels. Arch bridges, perfect for valleys or locations with solid foundations. Their curved shape naturally distributes weight. Suspension bridges, designed for very long spans, often exceeding kilometers. Think Golden Gate Bridge or Akashi Kaikyō Bridge. Cable stayed bridges, a modern favorite for medium to long spans, combining beauty and efficiency with fewer anchor points. Visual diagrams of each bridge type with real-world examples. The choice depends on many factors: the span length, the terrain and water depth, expected traffic and weight loads, budget and material availability. For instance, when building Japan's Akashi Kaikyō Bridge, engineers opted for a suspension bridge designed to span an enormous 1,991 meters, 6,532 feet, the longest of its kind at the time. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Civil Engineering Edge.